I'm in Premiere Pro 2023, and I'm going to transcribe and caption this short 37-second video. Where you want to go is under Edit. You've got Text here. If you don't see that, you can go up to your Windows and select it. It's pretty self-explanatory, as you can see. Here's the name of the video. And if you hit Transcribe, it will start transcribing it. This particular video only has one audio track. However, if you have multiple audio tracks, what it will do is it will give you an option of choosing which audio track you want to transcribe, or it'll give you a mix option so you can actually transcribe all of them at the same time. So as you can see, the transcription's done. If I start playing it back, this is going to be a real quick one, how to reverse a video in Premiere Pro. Follows along pretty well, and I'd say the transcription is pretty well done. Mine only took a few seconds because it's a short video. If you've got a long video that transcribing, keep in mind this is connecting to Adobe's cloud AI service, so it might take you a bit. You can edit this here if you'd like. So you've got this option here, just click Edit. And then that way, if you notice that there is any capture error between what you said and what's written, or maybe there's a spelling error, you can edit those and make the changes there. Now let's get out of there. I want to caption it. There's three ways actually to get to captions. Click this little caption option here. You've got this little CC icon here, or if you click this three little arrows, you've got create captions. If you don't want to do captioning, and let's say you just want to export this as a text file or a CSV file that maybe you're, it's like a handy service if you want to convert a video to a blog post or something like that, for example. So anyway, I want to create my captions, so I'm going to hit Create Captions. I'm going to get some preset options. In this case, I'm going to go Subtitle Default. I have a whole video on this channel. I'll post the link below on captions creating, and it goes into what these different options are. But I'm just going to leave it the default for this, and I'm going to go create captions. So as you can see here, it added the captions. Now they're really quite small and difficult to see. So I actually want to edit mine because they're too small. So I'm going to go up here and I'm going to check this option here, workspaces, and I'm going to go captions and graphics. All right, from within this view, if I click on one of the captions, you can see I get this essential graphics up here to the right. This is going to give me options. So if you've got something saved as a style, you can select that. I don't have anything saved on here. It gives you an option of changing your font and the size. So I'm going to actually update mine to maybe 55 to make it a little easier to read. I'm going to leave it in the center. You can do italics, all that kind of stuff. Align, so mine's aligned in this below center, but let's say maybe I want it to be showing on the top or somewhere else. I'm going to keep mine down in the bottom, but I am going to move it up just a little bit there, just again to make it a little easier to see. You can do a stroke, so maybe you want a red outline in that case. You can change the color of the font. I'm going to leave mine to white. I am going to get rid of my shadow, but I'm going to do a little background here. And you'll see this is kind of a nice feature for captions, I think, where change that to a black. And as you can see here, what it's doing is it's making it easier to read with a bit of a black outline around it. Okay, now let's say I really like this and I might want to use it again. How I mentioned saving track styles, so you can go and create, save that as a track style. And that way, if later on I want to use that, I can. Now, if I want to export these, when I go to export my video, I've got a couple options here. And again, I've got a whole video on transcriptions, so if I'm jumping over something here, feel free to go check that out. You can burn it into the video, or you can create a sidecar. Again, I go into that in the other video. I'm going to burn mine into the video. And that's pretty much it. So real quickly, that was transcribing and captioning. Again, if you want more detail on captioning, like editing captioning styles and that kind of stuff, go check out that other video. It's in the link below.